the previous video, we have seen the reaction of Grignard on carbonyl to give alcohol. And I have told you that during the preparation of Grignard or in the chain of the carbonyl, pay attention, avoid having an acidic H's. So no acidic H, no SO3H, no COOH, no OH, no NH2 in these reactions, okay? Because the acidic H, the Grignard will take, the reaction will take place here and not an insertion between RX and MG. So avoid the presence of these acidic H's. In the presence of OH and NH2, we have seen before that these groups can be blocked using OCH3, if you remember, and NHCH3 or NHCOCH3 or OCOCH3. For these two, you are not responsible on how to block them. Now we will continue with reaction 8 and 9 that are identical, which are the halogenation and alkylation. If you have a carbonyl compound, aldehyde or ketone, I will take for example an aldehyde, this is H-alpha. Don't forget that H-alpha next to the carbonyl is the most acidic H. So if you add a base, you have in your notes like HO- and H2-, RO-, I will take HO- here. The base will abstract the H-alpha to give here the carb anion. And this can act as a nucleophile. So if I want to do the halogenation, if you add X2, Cl2, Br2, I2, no F due to its size, so I will obtain X on position alpha. Or if you add, for example, RX alkyl halide C, you will have R on position alpha. Now, you can continue the reaction from here. You can do, for example, elimination to have a double bond here, then add on beta. You can substitute here by other group. Pay attention. So always, if you want to do a reaction, if you see a chain on a carbonyl with here you have substitution on alpha, beta, always, always think of doing the substitution by alkylation or by halogenation on alpha, then move to beta, etc. by elimination or nucleophilic substitution. Now, what will happen if the carbonyl, in the case of ketone, we have a carbonyl here with a chain substituted here and a chain, for example, linear here. Always, always, the acidic H is taken from the less substituted. Here we have steric effect, so always we work on this part of the chain. So this is concerning alkylation and halogenation. I repeat, always on alpha H's, which are the most acidic H's. If you don't have alpha H, okay, you cannot do it on beta. Pay attention. You must have H alpha to do alkylation or halogenation. Now we will move to, we still have three reactions to finish this chapter. We will move to Wittig reaction, which is completely a new reaction for you. What is Wittig reaction? Wittig is a reaction used to transform carbonyl to alkene. Okay, what do we need in this reaction? In this reaction, we need a triphenyl phosphine. We need RX alkyl halide, like CH3Br, and we also need a base. So we need the three things. So if you want to use this reaction directly without mechanism, if you want to transform, for example, this one to this one in the exam, you can directly place here for me P phenyl three times RX NaOH. What is the mechanism of the reaction? The mechanism of the reaction is a little bit complicated. Let's do it quickly. Okay. First of all, the triphenyl phosphine, you know phosphorus, like oxygen, nitrogen, has a free pair of electrons. It will attack the alkyl halide. Here I have taken the alkyl halide, the methyl bromide, so it will attack it. You will obtain P plus, it has lost its free pair of electrons, phenyl, phenyl, phenyl with CH3. Okay? Now you add the base. What will happen to this base? This base will abstract this H, which is the acidic H, to form a minus. So you will have P plus phenyl, 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 CH2 minus. This is the intermediate of the reaction, and this one will attack the function carbonyl. I will take, for example, as in your note, hexanone. So this will attack it, this will open, you will fall. Let's write it. What you will form, you will form a cycle. This one, O minus, you have P, CH2, pardon, P plus phenyl. This will come here to form a four-member drink cycle. And you know, inorganic four-member drink cycles are unstable. As you can see, they are easily decomposed. So if you form your four-member drink cycle, it will be OP phenyl with a CH2 here. It will be directly decomposed like this, and you will form a cycle of six with double bond CH2 plus P double bond O phenyl. Like this, we have transformed cyclohexane with a double bond to cyclohexane with a double bond C, not a double bond O. So this is Wittig reaction, a very important reaction to transform aldehyde and ketones, carbonyl, to alkene. Okay, now we will move to another reaction, which is the aldol condensation. Okay, it's the last reaction in your note. I will do it before the protection. So let's move one page. Aldol condensation. Aldol condensation is exactly the opposite of Cannizzaro. Okay, so it is 2 mole of aldehyde with H alpha to give the aldol. From the name, aldol, it means we have the same compound, the function. Aldehyde plus alcohol. How this will take place? Okay, so if you take a carbonyl, I can write it under this form, which is the keto, or by tautomerization, I can write it under the form of enol, right? So if you add a base, first we will lose the function enol. So the base will abstract this H from the function enol to form C, O minus H double bond C. Now I add the second mole of carbonyl under the form of this one, ketone. The minus will form double bond, and my double bond here will act as a nucleophile, forcing this one to open, and it will take H plus. And at the end, I will obtain the aldol, a compound containing the function alcohol and the function aldehyde. Okay, so you can read it in your notes. So I repeat, aldol is the condensation of 2 moles of aldehyde, usually the same aldehyde, with H alpha, so it's the opposite of Cannizzaro, to give an aldol, which is a compound containing the function aldehyde and alcohol in the same molecule. We still have one last thing to give: how to protect a carbonyl compound. And pay attention, this is very important. How to protect a carbonyl compound. So if you have, for example, if you are doing a reaction, you have carbonyl and other function, any other function, and you want to do the reaction here and not here, or if you have two carbonyl, I'm talking carbonyl, not carboxyl, aldehyde, and ketone, and you want to do the reaction on one and on the other, you must block the other. How to block carbonyl? Usually, we block carbonyl by transforming them to ether, which is not very reactive. So for this reason, for the carbonyl, as you can see in the two examples, we use diol. We can use 1,2-diol. The reaction is reversible. In this direction, it needs acidic media to de-block, as you can see later. We will see how to de-block. Or you can use a triol. It's the same with the 3 carbon. So you'll transform your carbonyl like this, OO with 2CH2, or OO with 3 carbon. This is an ether which is unreactive. What is the mechanism of the reaction? The mechanism, I will read it with you, okay? So, first of all, we have the protonation of the carbonyl. Pay attention, when you have carbonyl in acidic media, pay attention. Carbonyl are very reactive, more reactive than alcohol. Always the first step is the protonation. So you will obtain R C double bond O plus H R prime. Okay? You have protonated your carbonyl. Now the diol 1,2 or 1,3, it will attack, forcing this one to open. As you can see in your note, you will form RC. We have here OH, we have R prime, and this will form O plus H, CH2OH. It will lose its H plus to form O here. Okay, now what will happen? We will have another protonation, as you can see, another protonation of this one to form OH2 plus. This will attack it, and this a good leaving group will leave like this. You have the protection of your carbonyl. Let's see the example. If you see the example, so we have two functions. We have the function carbonyl, and we have the function carboxyl inside the ester. So if I want to transform, pay attention, if I want to transform this compound, to this compound. Okay. So if I add, it's a reduction reaction, lithium aluminum hydride, will use the function carbonyl and the function carboxyl. So I don't want to touch the carbonyl, as you can see. So it's a double bond here, not a single. Okay? So it will not touch it. So in order for lithium aluminum hydride to touch only the carboxyl and transform it to alcohol, I need to block this one. So what do I use? I use the diol. I block it, as you can see, I do the reaction, and at the end, to de-block my function carbonyl, I de-block it by acid hydrolysis, I add H2OH+. And like this, we have finished the chapter, the reactions of aldehydes and ketones.